Well, a milestone for Tlou Energy today. They've achieved first power from their coal bed methane project in Botswana, where the Lesedi gas field is hooked into generators. Managing Director Tony Gilby joins me now on Skype. Tony, good to see you.
Good morning, Andrew.
Tony, significant development here for you.
I think it's a very significant development, Andrew, in that this is the first CBM gas to power in the entire history of the country of Botswana.
Just remind us of the background. This gas was from the Salimo area of the Lesedi operation, right?
Correct. Our Salimo pilot has been flaring gas for over 12 months now. Excuse me, I've got a little bit of a croaky throat today, but we've been flaring gas for over 12 months in that gas and used it as the energy source for an electricity generator and converted the gas to electricity and therefore have achieved diesel savings at our project.
Very good. Remind us about how much resources Lesedi is estimated to host, Tony.
We have about 3,000 billion cubic feet of 3C independently certified contingent resources and about 250 BCF of 3P independently certified gas reserves.
We touched on it last time, but probably worth just going over again. In terms of power from coal bed methane, what are the benefits here over the likes of diesel and coal-fired power?
Well, there are many, many benefits over the use of diesel and coal. In replacing diesel at our own operation and ultimately throughout Botswana, the gas is a cleaner product and it will be cheaper than diesel. In terms of coal, it might be a little bit more expensive, but it's certainly a much cleaner product and indeed is supported by worldwide funding, whereas coal is finding it more difficult in that sense of time. So it's certainly cleaner than coal and diesel, and it will be cheaper than diesel.
Well, Tony, look, fair to say, certainly a very busy time for you at the moment. Aside from achieving first power this morning, we're just weeks out, of course, from that deadline for the request for proposal from the government there for that 100 megawatt power proposal. Remind us of the details.
Yes, the government has sought from two parties, including ourselves, a request to tender effectively for 100 megawatts of CBN fired a power generation. Now, we're doing all the background work on that at the moment. The group's working very hard along with our consultants, including feasibility studies and the like, to put forward a very robust application or bid, if you will, to the government in terms of that 100 megawatts of gas-fired power generation. And we would be very hopeful of achieving a good outcome.
Are you up against much competition in terms of others who have put tenders or will be putting tenders forward?
Our understanding is that the tender went to two parties, ourselves and one other, but of those two parties, we're the only ones with independently certified gas reserves and we're the only ones with a full environmental survey approval for upstream exploration and development. So we feel we're a long way ahead of the competition.
Well ahead of the competition, Tony. In terms of when you may hear back, you reckon it'll be more like months rather than weeks, do you think?
Oh, I think so. The Botswana government is very thorough in their evaluations and their processes. They won't make a right decision, I'm sure, based on a previous understanding of previous coal-fired tenders. It will take a period of time, but hopefully not too long.
And aside from all this, Tony, what else is on the agenda for you for the next 6 months? I suppose just working up additional reserves at Lesedi and Mumba, is it?
We're working up additional reserves. We're fully funded for our field program for this year, which is seismic and some core holes, and that should, all else being equal, add to our reserve position, which will continue to strengthen our position as a leading coal bed methane gas to power potential producer in the near term.
I know you're having a bit of difficulty talking there, Tony, so I'm not gonna force you into it for too much longer. But a final word, though, if we can. In your view, Botswana, you reckon, has all the ingredients for success as far as Tlou and coal bed methane is concerned?
Oh, absolutely. I believe that all the fundamental ingredients are in place for Tlou to be a very successful company within Botswana, having built on our position now for a number of years, having established the first independently certified gas reserves, the environmental approval, now first gas to power, albeit in a small way initially, to continue that de-risking of the project, and with a little bit of luck too, we'll secure a larger power project with the government in the not too distant future.
We look forward to hearing further from you, Tony. All the best. Hope you're feeling and sounding better soon.
Thank you very much, Andrew. Nice to chat.